Okay, so you've shaped the boule and you've put it in your perfume basket. You've let it rise for about 2 hours, giving maybe a little warm boost at the beginning. And it should be double in size, or pretty close, anywhere between 1.5 and double is fine. Should look a little something like that. What you're then going to do is grab your flour again. And you're going to sprinkle flour on the top of the boule, which actually will be the bottom of the boule in the end. So you want to sprinkle it pretty liberally, because this is what stops it from sticking to your counter and to the bottom of the Dutch oven. So pretty liberal sprinkling of flour there. And then I'm going to turn this out onto my counter. And you could do this in two ways. You could either flop it and kind of knock it against the cabinet, the counter, to knock it out. Or I like to kind of, you can sometimes knock too much air out of it that way. So I like to do it gingerly. I flip it into my hand and I kind of wiggle it out, kind of tease it out a little bit. Sometimes knock it a little bit with my fingers. I'll only be as ginger as possible, but it sometimes does require a little bit of work. So there you go, there's my boule. I turned out onto my counter. See that nice ringing from the proofing basket? And then I'm gonna grab my razor blade, and I've already grabbed my razor blade, and I'm gonna score it across into the top. I find you could use a regular knife, but the thinner the blade, the sharper the blade. Some people use a wet blade. I find just a regular old razor blade works great. You wanna cut about a quarter to a third of an inch deep, like that. And now you're ready to place it in your hot Dutch oven, which you've put in the oven. I've gotten it to temp with its heat shield at 475. So I'm gonna grab that from the oven now, my smoking hot Dutch oven. And then this step is kind of tricky. Here, I'm gonna take your lid off because your dough is gonna be pretty, your bread is gonna be pretty slack. So I'll get a bit of flour on my fingers, and you've got to kind of scoop it up carefully and plop it in. And it's okay if it gets a little bit out of shape. It'll kind of reshape itself a little bit by virtue of the shape of the Dutch oven. Put the lid on, and then we're going to put that in the oven. And I'm going to bake it for 20 minutes at that 475 with the lid on. And at the 20-minute mark, I'm going to take the lid off, and I'm going to do the remaining 10 to 15 minutes with the lid off to dry out that crust. So that's kind of the process for getting the dough from your proofing basket into the oven.